All right, guys, today we are going to be putting on a neutral release cover for Durango. Now, the issue with these are that even when you take off this little cover here, you can still see the two screws. They're right there. So even if you put the cover on, when they lift up on this little piece here and take it off, they can still see the screws. So all they have to do is use a Phillips head to remove the two screws, and then they get access to the switch here. But nonetheless, it will still delay them. It would help take more time for them to steal your vehicle. But again, it's just, you know, the way these Durangos were built is a little different from the Challengers and Chargers. It makes it a little easier to gain access and pull the neutral release switch. But anyways, let's get right into the video. All right, guys, so you can see how this switch is, how you would have to make the plate that covers this, because it's flat here, and then there's a part where it goes up. So that can be a little tricky, you know, as you can see there. But the plate we're going to make is going to come over. It's going to go down and go up under the two screws here. So it'll be basically covering up the switch, but the two screws will still be exposed. But when we make it, we may not be able to put this cover back on because of the way it was, you know, this little bump there. We have to come up, you know, the cover would have to raise up over that bump. So once we put the cover on, this may not be able to fit anymore. You know, that may not be able to fit, but we'll see. We'll see how it comes out because of that little bump, as you can see. You can see how it comes up right there. So the cover would actually come across. You'd secure it with a screw here, secure it with a screw here. And then I would like for it to be secured on the sides as well. Or maybe a screw here and a screw on this side. But again, the thing is, you got a power source down there. You got wires. So if you're going to screw a screw into this way, you'd have to be real careful. But again, it can be done. It just takes a lot of extreme precise measurements to get it right. So this is where I'm at. I got the sheet metal cut out. This is the full total length with, even with when we bend it, this is the length of it. I grinded it down so it's not short, real sharp on the edges. Don't cut your fingers up. But this is the start. And trust me, guys, there is a lot involved with these. So unfortunately, I will not be making these available for sale. All right, so this is where I'm at with it. This is what it looks like. It's going to go over the neutral release switch. Now, I've got to cut about a quarter inch right here because it's too long. I made sure my measurements was a little too long on purpose because I didn't want to come up short. So I could just cut off this extra, which isn't needed. But it should be 1 1/4 inch from here to here, 1 1/4 inch from here to here. There's a 1 inch drop right here. This is 3.5 inches, and it fits right over the top of the neutral release switch. But again, I'll cut this off here to make the exact measurement. Now, this took a lot of bending. I basically used a pair of large pliers and bent it. All of this is done by hand, so that's why it's a lot of work involved. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut this edge off and then go and see and test fit it. Okay, so it looked like it's lining up exactly right. So what I have to do is I have to get the exact location of the holes where there are this here and this here, and then a hole to put the screw down there. So I'll just get the exact location of there, then I'll drill holes into the cover, and that should pretty much be it.
So basically I just traced a hole where this is where the screw would go on each side. And then this is where that little rivet that's sticking out would go to kind of mount it all in place. So I'm gonna go ahead and screw out these holes and then come back and test fit it. Now, when drilling out the holes here, make sure the screw hole, you don't drill it too big because you want the screw to fit snug in there. That's very important. So test one smaller, then go test fit it and see if that's small enough or big enough. And that one there, it won't really hurt to make that a little bit too bigger because that's going to go over top of that little rivet that's sticking out that part there. All right, so we got the holes drilled out. We'll go ahead and see how these fit. If they don't fit, we'll just come back and make some adjustments. Now, I'll give you guys all the measurements just in case, and all the materials and everything, just in case you want to make these. Because
okay, so I got to drill these holes a little bigger right here because it won't go all the way down. That hole I got to drill a little bigger. The screw hole looks to be spot on, but these holes I got to drill a little bit bigger. So go do that right now and come right back. Okay guys, so this is the final product. We're going to go ahead and test it out, see how it fits. Okay, that side slid right on perfectly. And the other side slid right on perfect. Okay, so now we'll go ahead and grab the two screws and see how those fit. So everything is lining up perfectly. Go ahead and grab the screws and make sure these things fit in. Oh, they went right in. Perfect. That is awesome. Now, what I may do is I may grab a special kind of screw, you know, for the would-be thief. You know, he may come with the standard screwdrivers like Phillips and a flathead. But if you have a special screw, that'll leave him a little bit more unprepared. So I may go grab a couple screws. But as of right now, guys, everything is lining up perfect. Here's the other screw on the other side. And that is perfect.
Okay, so in order to gain full access to the neutral release switch, move your seat all the way forward, passenger and driver. Go down here, pop off a little clip here, just like this. Use a pry tool. You'll pop that little thing out. And inside there's a 10 millimeter. Use a 10 millimeter to unscrew that. There's one on each side. Then you'll need to remove the armrest. All right. So again, you'll go in here, pop off this little cover here, pop. Then to remove the armrest, all it is three screws and there are four heads. Three Phillips screws, one, two, three. Once you remove those screws, the whole armrest will come completely off. Once the armrest is off, you'll be able to pull back on this. You can see where I use my pry tool. There's a little gap there. You'll be able to pull back on this and pull these to the side, on each side. That way you'll have full access to down in here where you can kind of get your measurements and work with this here. So that's pretty much it. You know, remove the cover, move the seat forward, remove the two caps there, 10 millimeter, then remove your armrest, and then just pull back and you'll be able to get back in here and work. There'll be enough space in there once you pull these back. So that's pretty much it. Real simple, three screws, one, two, and three for the armrest. Then you'll be able to go in there. But again, this is how it works. You know, the would-be thief will go in there, he'd go up in your armrest, look for the neutral release switch, and boom, he's blocked, you know, blocked fully. He'd have to use a screwdriver to remove these. But again, once you put your cover on, it might be helpful to change these to like a torque screw. Use a torque screw. That way, you know, he'll be a little bit off guard when he sees a torque screw. The common thief will probably have, you know, if he's, you know, expecting this, he's going to have like a Phillips head and a flathead. But if there's a torque screw in there, he's probably going to be unprepared for that. Also, now this cover, it may not go back on because, you know, this is an inch high right here. So
this isn't going to fit back on there. So it's just, as soon as they open a glove box, the would-be thief, he's going to see that cover. You know, there's no more of this, it's extra cover here, because it won't fit. No, it will no longer fit. Only way you can make it to fit is if you make the height of this a little bit shorter, probably about an eighth of an inch or maybe even a quarter of an inch. But I made it this tall just so I don't have to backtrack my work. I made it a little bit taller just in case. I didn't want to be too short. So again, you know, you won't need this little cover here if you use the measurements that I used. So just giving you a heads up on that.
All right. So first off, I started with a sheet of sheet metal and I cut an 8.5 total inch in length. It was a flat piece of, I think, like about an eighth of an inch sheet metal. Okay, so start with that. From here to here, this is going to be 3.5 inches. From here to here. Now from here to here, this is 1.625 inch wide. Now here there's a drop. It goes down. This is exactly a 1 inch drop from top to bottom. So you got the 3.5 and then you have a 1 inch drop. And again, all this is done by bending the sheet metal. And then from here, from the bottom of the drop, from here to here, you have 1.25. So that's from here to here, you have 1.25. That's on both sides. 1.25, 1.25.
And this is pretty much the sheet metal I used. It's about a 1/8 inch thick. This is it. That's all you need. You can get this at Home Depot or Lowe's. Real cheap. I think this sheet costs like maybe 10 bucks, something like that. It's real cheap. All right, guys. So here's a couple diagrams to maybe help you understand a little bit more of the measurements that I used. So here from the top of the cover is 3.5 inches. That's from the top. Now there's a drop where you would bend it. As I was showing you, you would bend the cover. That's a 1 inch drop. This will bring you to the bottom of the plate cover, and that is 1.25 inch on each side. That's what you'll need. Now, the width of the cover itself from here to here, the width of it is 1.625 inch, 1.625 inches. So that's important because you don't want it to be any wider than that, because it'll intrude on being able to close your armrest. So that 1.625 is the measurement you want. It can even be maybe 1/16 of an inch shorter. So again, once you put this neutral cover on, you won't need that extra little plastic cover that goes on under the armrest, because, you know, this cover will be just kind of sticking up just a tad bit. The cover won't be able to fit back on. But again, you'll have the protection from a would-be car thief. These are the measurements. You guys have any questions, drop a comment below. I'll definitely try to get back and respond to those. But if you follow these measurements, you should be spot on. If you have a 20, I know it'll fit from an 18 to 20 Dodge Durango. Probably doesn't matter any submodel. If you have a GT, RT, SRT, or whatever, those are going to fit. Now, if you have a 14 through 17, the measurements may be slightly different. So you may want to check those and double check to make sure, you know, you got the right measurements, because those may be slightly different for older models. But again, hope you guys enjoy the video. Hope this helped you out. I definitely won't be making these covers because it is definitely a bit much. I'll leave all the tools that I use in the description. So I'd appreciate if you guys give the video a thumbs up. Definitely subscribe to the channel. We got more great content on the way. I will see you guys in the next video. Alex's RT Life signing off.